also a movie review. This may be once a week, maybe twice a week. I don't really know. It's been a while since I've really watched any kind of movies besides going out to the theater. I've been recently inspired by a particular good friend of mine, and I've been wanting to just see some good films, and not necessarily films that I prefer. Films with good stories, of course. Of course, I prefer more tragic art, films with heart, but I'm also open to other films that I have no clue what they're about, some foreign films, and just taking basically a random shot and picking a film, enjoying it for what it is, not reading any reviews. Pretty much it. And of course, I probably will rewatch some films that I've already seen and that have been out for a long time, and offer my little thoughts on that. So this isn't going to be like a professional Siskel and Ebert type review. This is going to be me explaining the film, talking about some of my favorite scenes, and doing my best to share my thoughts on it and explain it to anyone out there who hasn't seen it, might not ever see it. So there may be some spoilers in here, but I'll try not to go into too many details. But if I do, you've been warned. Alright, well, first we're going to start off with the beer review. So just bear with me a second. Christmas Ale. Since 1993, plenty of good cheer, good friends ever near. Fine Colorado Ales, Breckenridge Brewery. Brewed and bottled by Breckenridge Brewery of Colorado. It's got a 7.4% ABV. So, and there's the bottle cap. Hopefully you can see it okay. And it's got a nice little kind of a festive classic kind of label. Might be drinking water, this ale doesn't really describe what it may or may not be brewed with, so. Ale. I give this a nice 3.5, close to 4 stars, I guess. It's a little above average. I mean, I like it. I'm not sure. Again, I'm not an expert on ales and what's used in them as far as hops or said, we're going to talk about the movie Drive. And 5-star movie from me. A beautiful story. A lot of heart. It's based on a book, and I'm going to have to cheat here a little bit. Because, I'm old and I'm lazy and I don't like to memorize much anymore. So we have Ryan Gosling as the driver, but it's based on the book by James Salas. And basically it's a movie about this. Synopsis. A mysterious Hollywood stuntman, mechanic, and getaway driver lands himself in trouble when he helps out his neighbor. So Ryan Gosling is this part-time stuntman or stunt driver for Hollywood films. It's based in LA, for 5 minutes. Anything within there, within that time frame, you'll be there for the people. You know, as their driver. But anything outside that 5 minute window, you know, he's gone or what have you. And the movie opens up with him explaining exactly that. He's in a motel room or a hotel room. And it looks like a hotel room. And it opens up with him being a getaway driver for a robbery or something. And he almost gets caught, but he gets away. And there's a lot of... And then I'm not good with these reviews, so you're going to have to bear with me here. But he's playing this dual life. He's and he's very quiet. The entire mood of the film is very subdued. It's got some action scenes in it, but they're very short. There are some intense violent scenes, which I loved because they're somewhat unique. And not that I love violence, but they kind of make sense. It's not just gratuitous violence. And the film is shot like very high contrast, so it's real vivid, but it's also got this, it has this stylish, somewhat edgy kind of look, gritty look and feel to it. You would say photographic. I'm trying to. They don't say, what is it, cinematography. But it's got some great scenes in it, some. A few decent shots of LA and the various. You know, the. Of the city and on the skyscrapers at night. Things like that. Typical shots like that. It's got a decent car scene in it, a couple car chase scenes, but it's not so much about that, and it's got a little bit of romance in it. Ryan Gosling, he meets this woman next door, he moves into a new place, I think, or maybe it is his permanent place where he lives. I didn't quite get that, but I think it might be his permanent place, because when the film opened up, it looked like he was in a different room or place altogether. I don't know, but he kind of finds a love interest in Carrie Mulligan. She plays Irene, and she lives next door, and she is married to a guy who's in jail, and she has a son, and he kind of, you know, bumps into her in the elevator. I think how it happens, but yeah, they just kind of casually, he's going up to the fourth floor, and she gets on, and she has a short blonde hair, and they kind of, you know, glance at each other, and then he notices that she's right next door. And then he notices her at the local supermarket or market. And her car kind of breaks down or has some issues in the parking lot of the market. he's there. Of course, he's a mechanic too. So she ends up taking it to where he works. And so there's that going on. But then the mechanic who runs the shop that Ryan Gosling works for, you know, he's also an acquaintance with some mafia types. And it's, I don't want to give too much away, and I don't want to really go into explaining every part of the movie, but Ryan Gosling gets involved because there's like this this circle of events that happen that involve Ryan Gosling and the mechanic shop owner and this love interest of his. Her husband comes back and he was in jail and he's in debt to some people. So they want him to do a robbery, and the robbery is kind of related to the mafia types that this mechanic shop owner is tied to, and he's also telling them, you know, that he can get them, you know, if he gets them, if they can help him with a race, a NASCAR, like a somewhat stock car race, and Ryan Gosling is the driver, you know, he'll be able to help them with, you know, give them some money and start his new little kind of business thing. But it's a really touching movie. Ryan Gosling, he's just a great actor. And he doesn't have a lot of lines. He plays a very moody character. He's got a lot of, I don't know if he has anxiety or anger, but he plays it cool. But he loses his cool at some parts. And he's got a very violent side to him. And you're not really sure where that comes from, what his past is. You just know that he shows up as a, you know, working as a mechanic. He's good with cars. He's a driver. He's a good driver. And, you know, the husband comes back out of jail, and Irene, she starts to fall for the driver. He doesn't really have a name, and he falls for her, but she's also in a relationship, and you know she's fallen for Ryan, and there's the driver, I should say, and there's a couple of cool scenes that I like, because I'm a bit of a hopeless romantic at heart, and her husband's back, and Ryan Gosling tries to help out her husband, or the driver, I should say, tries to help out her husband, because he's trying to, you know, he got beat up, when he comes back, he gets beat up because he owes money to these people, whatever, and, you know, she invites the driver over to her place, and he's gotten kind of close with her and her son, because while the husband was away, you know, that's when he kind of bumped into her, and, you know, he takes her out on a date, and that's when she tells him her husband will be back in a week, and you just have this shot of Ryan Gosling, or the driver, I'll just say, Ryan Gosling, I guess, just staring, you know, into space, like, just when everything was going good, now it's not going so well, but she invites him over, and it's a great scene I like because, you know, her husband's back, and she's not really in love with her husband. She's kind of falling for Ryan, but she invites Ryan over because he's also friend, you know, trying to help out the husband. And the husband's talking and stuff, and her and Ryan, Irene, and the driver exchanging glances and things like that. And the husband doesn't really know too much. And they don't really ever sleep together, or you don't know that they slept together. I don't think they did. They don't really play the direction of their romance isn't really explored, but I like that. I respect that a lot. You know, sometimes there's, I hate to say gratuitous, but there's unnecessary sex scenes in films that you don't really need to explore that all the time. South for everybody, and I'm not really gonna say much, but it has a very interesting ending that I love. It's you don't really know what happens to a couple of the characters. I'm just gonna say I'm not gonna really. If you plan on watching it, you probably don't want to watch the rest of this. But basically, Ryan Gosling, he gets caught up in this whole mafioso, if that's how you say it, circle between the girl's husband coming back. He owes a debt. He's Ryan offers to be his driver. He gets shot and killed. He goes to rob a pawn shop. He gets just shot and killed. It was a setup. The mafia types were using him to steal because apparently there's these other mafia types from Philly that were trying to encroach on the LA mafia. And so they're trying to steal from them to kind of stop them from encroaching into their territory. And Ron Perlman plays Nino, this head mafia type. And there's this great scene where Ryan Gosling, you know, Nino is trying to kill everybody. You know, he's part of the reason why that the girl's, Irene's husband gets killed. Set up pretty much. That's kind of classic, but it was directed well and written well. So you really didn't. While there were some elements of the movie that were kind of stereotypical crime drama moments, the way it was written and directed, you really didn't know that they were, you know, typical movie elements of the mafia and the setup and all that, and it caught me off guard. I didn't know what to expect of this movie, and it was great. Ryan Gosling is really smart. He plays a smart character. I gotta read the book, but there's some really brutally violent scenes. Scene in particular that I thought was just great. It had me on the edge of my seat, and Ryan is meeting with Irene. The driver is meeting with Irene, and husband, and he's sorry that he got involved and he tried to help, but, you know, he was there when he got killed, and she slaps him and all this, and I forget exactly what point, but the elevator doors open and there's this guy, and I don't know if he said something, oops, wrong floor or something. So Irene goes to get on, and the driver gets on with her, and the driver is looking at the guy on the elevator is looking at him, and the driver knows something's up. He takes a look at the guy, and he can see there's a gun inside of his blazer, his suit. So he goes like this to Irene to kind of put her behind him. And then he turns around, he turns his back to the guy, and he kisses her. And it's a really intense, you know, it's a deep kiss, and it's a really intense moment. And I thought he was going to get shot. But they break the kiss. And he goes and attacks the guy, because the guy was pretty much sent there to kill him. It's a long story, but basically the driver ends up getting in contact with Nino, the mafia guy, the head mafia guy, telling him he has the money and things like that. But the mafia guy sends this crony out, and that's the guy in the elevator. So he kisses Irene, and then he goes and beats the crap out of the guy in the elevator, and he just starts stomping on his face and breaking his face in. And Irene is like, what's going on? The elevator finally goes down into the parking lot or the garage. And, you know, she backs out into the garage, and you can see him. He's like, he's pouring sweat, and he's just like a wreck. And then he finally comes out of his violent rage and turns around and looks at Irene, and she's just scared. She's like, what's going on? Not really scared, but she's just like in shock of seeing this side of him. And that was a great, I don't know, that was like a 5-minute scene, and that was a beautiful scene. I love that. It was intense. And, you know, he didn't want her to see that side of him, but he just lost control. So it was a great film. Definitely 5 stars. I definitely would like to own that. I could watch it again and again. You know, Ryan Gosling, he plays such close-vested, and no emotion, just very dry character. But then you see when he meets this girl and the son and her son, he starts to show this caring side of him. And there's a great soundtrack too. There's this one song about you're a real human being, you're a hero. It's a lot of nice, there's a nice soundtrack to it, and just the whole mood of the film is a little bit gritty, but not too gritty. It's very chill. It's got some action moments in it and some tense moments in it, but it's just a nice drive of a film. I liked everything about it, so I highly recommend it, of course. If you're a fan of Ryan Gosling, you won't be disappointed. But if you're a little queasy on violence, there might be some scenes that you might not be able to take. They don't really bother me too much. But It's a great movie, and I want to say thanks to those of you who recently recommended that movie when I did my other ASMR. I think it was number peer review number 20. I talked about movies. Or 19. I forget. I don't really keep count. And so that was just it's not too dark. It's got some nice bright moments. It doesn't get real heavy emotionally. Well, it does at some points, but It's got a real good ending to it. And, there's a lot of great scenes, and I think it tells a really good story. So, yeah, what more can I say? It was a great movie. I loved it. Explained it well. I'm not really good at doing these reviews, but it's not really so much about trying to do a review as more it is just to kind of connect and talk about a movie that some of you might have watched or haven't seen yet, and just trying to relax and hang out. This is kind of a casual way for me to just to share my thoughts on the movie. So that was a very enjoyable beer too. Breckenridge Christmas Ale. I could drink that again. I don't think it's anything too special about it, but it's not bad. You know, I give it a good 3.5 stars, like I said. So so thumbs up for the Christmas Ale by Breckenridge, and thumbs up for Drive. And so I recommend it, and stay tuned for some more movie reviews. Hopefully you enjoy this. I may not be coherent, as of course having a beer doesn't help, but hey, this is just a laid back thing. It's all just